The S10 is a yet fictional suburban railway between Bernau and the yet fictional airport Berlin-Brandenburg. It does not only connect Berlin with Brandenburg, it also connects the north and the south of Berlin's east, which feels so far, far away, so close. The tracks, the space above and aside it, are new territories in the best sense. We did a one-day-long field trip, a section through the city, as a start to discuss the potentials of this new territory.
Envoy, imprisoned by four walls, to the north the crystal of non-knowledge, a landscape to be invented, to the south reflective memory, to the east the mirror, to the west stone and the song of silence. I wrote messages but received no reply. Octavio Pez. In our analysis we divided the whole area of M10 line in three bigger parts, which are dealing with various identities. Defining those identities was our starting point for giving a proposal through different approaches. The northern part of the M10 line was defined as a small-scale building structure area in form of single housing with private properties and rural, aka agricultural character. The middle part, Hohenschönhausen, is a big-scale structure with high residential building, offering no space for any cultural, communal, educational exchange. The third part, ending with the airport Schönfeld, is defined by mixed neighborhood, making a polycenter, densified and highly developed. The form of the structure is referring on the existing areas, their topographic, urban and our conceptual development. Firstly, we have a living wall beside the line. In the middle, we have a bridge as a city center. And at the end, there is a polyfunctional structure around the line. The city is growing up, mostly radial. Horizontal urban density is occupying the space and landscape. Instead of building horizontal, I am proposing high-rise living wall in form of a megastructure with other public facilities. It will afford protection of landscape, area and fields. Not only to protect them, it's possible to use them and develop agricultural industry and production. This situation will make the sustainable self-managed city and community where living and working stays together in the most effective way. Nature stays protected and the production is afforded. In the second case, Hohenschönhausen became a city, but it's only residential high-rise city without any developed city center, with public facilities where people could gather, meet, exchange and so on. Proposal for this situation is to build a bridge above the metro line, intersecting the existing structure. In the immediate surrounding, the street axes are intersecting the bridge, where vertical circulation is connecting different levels, ground floor and upper public level, blue marked. The program depends on the necessities of its citizens. It could be their market, swimming pool, open air theater, bar, shop, line for runners, cyclists and so on. On the other hand, the new city center stays in the middle of the M10 line, connecting south and north. David will explain his prototype based in the southern part of our line.
The idea is to simply bridge the infrastructure lanes, which often divide the land or the cityscape, and to create an elevated common ground. This space should be easy to access and the mediator between both sides. It's treated in the same way as the surrounding and can be used by the public to build flats or to grow vegetation, also all at the same time. The structure is based on an 8x8 meter grid with a height of 7 meters and covers the whole track. It can fit the S-Bahn as well as the regular trains. An interesting point we discussed was the perception of speed and the visual relation to the environment passengers have when riding the S-Bahn, especially in contrast to the U-Bahn. We ask ourselves which qualities we want to maintain or enhance, and some ideas will be explained later on. On top of the slab is modular housing on a 4x4 meter grid placed. The idea is that the whole structure can adapt to the needs of the people living there, and a single unit can be combined with one or multiple units next to it. In this way, it's possible to create a huge variety of living situations in a generic megastructure, which can also change over time. The project always responds to its environment. In denser surrounding, it can grow and enter a dialogue to its context, but at the same time it can just serve as a crossing for the rail where no densification is wanted or needed. It is also possible to enlarge the structure for site-specific services and facilities in the ground floor, where Thomas analyzed more in detail.
In this scenario, the topic of speed, scale and perception should be applied on one specific part of our megastructure, the so-called living wall. It is located in the northern part of the S10, an area which is defined by small-scale living and agriculture. The elevated train track as the fastest component of the building is structured by the rhythm of long storage spaces and long gap spaces in between, which are spanning about 100 meters. The gap spaces act like windows that give the passengers a distant focus over the vast fields and landmarks in the back, which gives a pleasant feeling of being orientated. The elevated common ground of the building is predominated by walking pace. The focus is now controlled by details. The busy plaza with all the people leads to distraction, so the eye will only be catched by the distinctive focus of details that are highlighting the place. That could be sport facilities, bars, or other special programs. The last and slowest part of the building is the living wall itself. This is also the most sheltered or private territory of the building. The situation may allow you to control your own perception the most by basically deciding what you focus on. So we could maybe speak of a reflective focus, which is encouraged by the lack of distraction and a slow pace.
As it has been said, the East Banana is a very heterogeneous environment. The S10 is the possibility how to connect it. It is a megastructure, a 55 kilometers long building. Its structure changes according to its environment, but any form it takes, the structure always provides a view outside from the train, whether to the fields or to the inside life of the building. In the countryside, it's the elevated train core, but with rising housing density, the density of the structure rises too. In its most developed form, it is composed of the train core surrounded by public space. This means streets, roads or station area. In another layer, there are public services such as cafes, retail, culture and sport facilities and offices above. The last layer is housing, distant enough from the noise and vibrations. To bring light into the structure, the volume of the building is divided into private vertical segments, laying on the public horizontal part.
Designing a new S-Bahn connection, there appears the thought of the meaning of the S-Bahn station within this process. Not only in this specific superstructure, but in general meaning in an urban territory. The station is a point connecting various movement forms concerning changing from one way of moving to another, from one speed scale to another, and from one place to another. Therefore, it conserves a side-by-side of all those movement ways and actors. This organic knot needs to be implemented in the present traffic system. This might even mean a shift in our perception of how we move through the developing city. whether we move only ourselves with baggage or restriction, or how fast we move should affect our choice of mobility. There's a certain necessity of organizing those different layers to provide their coexistence. Designing the S10 means designing 5 new S-Bahn stations along this line. Therefore, one needs to adapt on or strengthen the present individual situation. What kinds of layer will be crossing? What is the dominant mobility way? And what does this mean for the present local structure and development state? One of those stations will be at S-Turmbahnhof Kreuz Karow, connecting S-Bahn and the Deutsche Bahn, as well as the local infrastructure. This station belongs to the small-scale living and agriculture structure along the S10. In detail, it not only means a more attractive connection for the people living in this intersection, but even strengthening the pedestrian and bicycle connection to the station to release the stress by car on the local streets. In the end, lifting the infrastructure above and beneath the ground eliminates the present barrier and furthermore provides a new territory, whether it's a public space, strengthening the local infrastructure, or providing social infrastructure. In the end, this intersection of movements in a station can mean a starting or strengthening point of urbanity and an empowerment of a specific area in terms of identity and overall orientation.
When I first heard about S10, I was thinking like, what a mess. That's why I felt the need to kind of classify the 55 kilometers in order to understand the structure at all. The initial approach was therefore to analyze the area on a large scale. Not surprisingly, completely opposite descriptions and challenges came to light. Because I found exactly this diversity exciting, I came up with the idea of designing small interventions for each of the sections. The idea behind this is that before building new homes on the open countryside, you should first use the existing potentials and eliminate the deficits in order to attract new residents. A polycentric city can only function if outer districts are equally attractive. The first section I have identified stretches from Bernau in the very north to Malchow. Basically, it consists of small-scale living structures and agriculture. What I found most interesting after the visit was that the houses were kind of isolated. For example, there is a big fence around each small of them. In addition, many old people live partly alone in these houses. As a small intervention, I have therefore imagined a separate staircase through which these houses can be better utilized and which also can bring different generations together. People can also move to the outskirts without having to buy an entire house. The second section is the exact opposite. In Marzahn or Hohenschönhausen, large-scale buildings and structures dominate. What interests me most, however, is the kind of misused space between the buildings. Because nothing happens there except of parking the car, it increases the monofunctionality of the area. This is also a reason why few people want to move there. As an intervention, I have therefore orientated myself on David's modular megastructure. The small building blocks can also fit perfectly as a meeting place in this area. These places are freely available for everyone and can help to improve the community life in the neighborhood. The last section around Köpenick is kind of a mixture of the first two and already works well as an independent polycenter. The uses of space are to a large extent very balanced. Therefore, there is only a small improvement potential in this last section. I suggest to find remaining vacant areas and convert them into mixed districts. It is essential to preserve public space and involve citizens in the process.
The map of Berlin or any other historical city suggests the concept of circularity.
What would it mean to have a longitudinal city? How would it affect our daily aesthetics and dynamics? A longitudinal city naturally leads to a moving city. What if not the person reaches the place, but the place reaches the person? What it means to be surrounded by ever-shifting landscape? The line itself has neither a beginning, nor an ending, nor a center. How would a linear form affect the content? What it would be like living in the city without borders? In the very beginning, before settling down, the city was composed of people in motion searching for better territories. Migration itself is the first model of urbanism and is very present once again. Digital nomads, refugees, expansion of all the cities, rent rather than ownership, all this calls for one thing, that is change. In the case of Berlin and our S10 proposal, I'm suggesting to transform infrastructure into the city itself. Here in the diagram, the upper line stands for different services reaching the speed from 30 to 40 kilometers per hour, which is the pace of the existing S-Bahn. The middle line stands for the street in between two moving structures, providing the ability of self-movement, such as walking, riding, bike, or jogging. The bottom line stands for the housing area, moving considerably slower. All well connected to the city center makes it possible to experience both central area and suburbs.
As we see, with implementing a new S-Bahn line in the eastern periphery, there arise more questions than the one of where new territories can be developed. By roughly analyzing and comparing a few data like inhabitants, supply of restaurants, or educational offers, I realized that creating just living space could have a huge and maybe fatal impact in the different areas. In order to realize a polycentric development, issues like necessary infrastructure and how to create a certain degree of humanity have to be discussed within the whole process, as well as all stakeholders and affected inhabitants should be able to take part in the discussion. Furthermore, the project must be promoted to stimulate a discussion among the general public. The length of the track and diversity of impacts that may occur make it a very complex project and need a structure or schedule. A space where demands and ideas can be contributed and the project as a whole can be communicated. As stations are centers, points of exchange, and actually the source of the impact that the project might bring with it, a space of communication should be created right at those spots. I'm thinking of a converted railway wagon, either as a single wagon or as a wagon of an entire train. This can drive off the individual stations and inform at the respective places and encourage taking part. It could be used as storage for some platform interventions, as indoor discussion area or moving representation of the new S-Bahn project, where people can participate, share ideas and get into dialogue with the stakeholders. Lastly, it can be used as an exhibition car for design proposals of the strategic development, newly designed stations or housing projects along the S10 track. So, let's begin with some track talk.
Among us, love. against the kingdom's throne. So people get ready, there's a train a-coming. You don't need no baggage, you just get on board. All you need is faith to hear the diesel's humming. Don't need no ticket, you just faith.